Hi there, welcome to Yaki Talks Games. I'm your host, Yaki Margulies, and today we're going to look at a fairly intense board game, Dead of Winter, from Plaid Hat Games. Look at those dark monochromatic color tones. You know it's serious. This is a 2-5 player game. It takes 1 to 2 hours, and it's ages 13 and up. In Dead of Winter, you control a number of survivors trying to make it through the middle of winter in Alaska. I think that's where it's set. Trying to find supplies and food and survive the cold while also dealing with zombies. Because there's always zombies. Players have banded together to create a colony, which is the main board where everyone is supposed to be the safest, but there's still tons of zombies there too. And survivors are leaving the colony to go to exterior locations to search for food and medicine and fuel and tools and sometimes weapons and my personal favorite, books. There's some interesting titles you can read that teach you some fun skills. All the while, you're risking exposure to the elements and to the zombies. I'm not going to go into the full rules explanation, but just to give you a taste of how this game works, each player is usually going to be controlling a number of survivors. Each survivor has their own card, which shows their name and their job, and also their influence, attack, and search values, as well as some special abilities. Because survivors are going to be searching for things, and also fighting zombies, and occasionally each other. And in case you're wondering what an influence value is, it basically determines who dies first in certain situations. To win the game, you have to complete your objective. The game comes with 10 objective cards, one of which you pick up top, and everyone's working together to accomplish that goal. Also, everyone will have their own secret personal goal. And the tricky thing is that of those personal goals, someone might have one that says that they are a traitor. So while everyone's trying to complete the main objective and their own secret personal objective, one player might be also trying to ruin it for everybody. You lose this game if you run out of time, because each objective comes with a set number of rounds, or if you lose all of your morale. And there are a lot of ways to make the morale go down. Each round, you're going to also be dealing with a crisis card. So in addition to your objectives, you also have to solve a crisis every round, like getting extra food, or medicine, or tools. This is a stressful game. In addition to dealing with these crises, you're also going to be sending survivors out of the colony to various locations like the police station, or the school, or the library, and you're going to be fighting zombies out there and searching each location's personalized deck for supplies. Your main objective might be something like you need to collect a lot of food by the end of the game to feed everyone, or you need to collect zombie samples, or you need to stockpile weapons and gas or something. So you're going to be searching a lot to try to get everything you need before you run out of rounds. If the last survivor you control dies, you're not out of the game, you'll just get a new survivor and you'll start over. But every time somebody dies, or usually if you fail to deal with a crisis, you lose morale. And again, if you have zero morale, you lose the game. And to give the game a little more narrative, there's a crossroads deck, which is a very cool idea. When it's your turn, another player will draw a card from the crossroads deck and not tell you what's on it. If you happen to do something on your turn that triggers that card or activates that card, then the person will read the card aloud. It's got some dark flavor text, and it'll usually present you with an option. You can do something that's maybe a little bit risky, but maybe gives you a reward if you take that risk, or something that's maybe playing it a little more safe, but you don't get anything. Some of the crossroad cards are very helpful, and some of the crossroad cards are just gloomy and bad for all of you. But it's a cool way to add some extra story and flavor and characterization to this already darkly themed game. At the end of each round, you check to make sure you have enough food to feed everybody, you make sure you've dealt with the crisis, and then the real bad thing is you add zombies to the game. Wherever humans are, they're attracting zombies, and so more zombies show up at the end of every round. And then one more thing I want to say about the gameplay is the dreaded exposure die. Pretty much any time you go to another location or you fight a zombie, you have to roll the exposure die for your survivor. The exposure die has 4 different outcomes on its sides. You could roll a blank, which is the best case scenario. You could roll a skull, which means your survivor takes a wound and they can only take 3 wounds before they die. You could roll a frostbite, which is the same as a wound, except at the start of each turn, you continue to get more wounds from that frostbite unless you cure it. And finally, one side of this 12-sided exposure die shows a tooth, and that's a zombie bite. And that's the worst of all because you immediately die, and the effects of the bite can spread to other people at that location. So, along with the stress of everything else you're dealing with in this game, the exposure die also adds another level of anxiety as you try to go anywhere or fight zombies and hope that you don't get infected. And in a very brief nutshell, that's how you play Dead of Winter. So let's talk about it a little bit more now. An interesting thing about Dead of Winter is it combines game styles. Its theme is very Ameritrash, as they call it, fighting zombies and stuff, but its gameplay is actually quite a bit like a worker placement Euro game. You're moving your guys around to search for resources to build up your stockpiles. And there's actually not that much fighting, and the fights are pretty brief. But what I really like about it is the theme. There are so many zombie games in existence, but I think this is one of the best ones because it's not purely about the zombies. You're also dealing with darker themes of survival and the thought of losing your own humanity. Sometimes you have to make choices, like you come across a baby in an abandoned house, and it asks you, do you want to take this baby in or leave it and just collect your own supplies so you don't have to have another mouth to feed? And there aren't that many board games that give you such a morbid decision you have to make. So I like how this game tells some very complex and interesting stories as you play it and make you sometimes ask bigger existential questions about your own humanity. Another thing I like about this game is the characters. It adds a lot of replay value because every time you play, you're going to be a number of different survivors, and each one has its own unique feel and stats and abilities, and you can do different things with them that really change the narrative of the game each time you play it. You might be a firefighter, or a pilot, or a nurse, or a cook, or a farmer, and they're all interesting in their own way. I also appreciate that every location you go to has a different personalized deck. So if you search in any specific location, you will find specific things there that you won't find necessarily at other locations. If you go to the police station, you're more likely to find weapons. If you go to the grocery store, you can find food. If you go to the library, you can find books. And that brings me to the last thing that I want to say about this game that I really like is the humor. This game injects some much-needed humor, sparsely, but it does it here and there, amidst the otherwise depressing themes of this game sometimes. And the humor really makes the stories shine. There's not too much of it, which I think is the perfect amount, to really highlight the sometimes ridiculous nature of this game. For instance, you could discover a book on karate that helps you fight zombies better. And some of the characters are kind of funny. I think most people's favorites will be the dog. It can really lighten the mood when you have a dog come in at the last second and fight some zombies, or grab some fuel to help solve the crisis. How does the dog grab the fuel? So even in its darkest moments, this game brings some levity, which I enjoy. Now, there aren't too many things that I dislike about this game, but I will bring up some negative factors briefly. One thing is, it does take a little while to set up this game. There's a lot of little pieces and decks of cards and things, and it can be a real bummer if you spend a lot of time setting up and explaining the rules to your friends, and then you start playing and immediately everything goes horribly wrong and the game doesn't even last very long. And that brings me to my main point about this game that I maybe don't love is it is hard. This game is very difficult, and if you're the kind of person who only gets enjoyment from games by winning, then this is not the game for you. Because I find we lose most of the time. Sometimes we win and it feels very good. It's very rewarding to win in this hard game. But a lot of the time you lose, so you just kind of have to enjoy the journey and not be too focused on the outcome of the game. Even when we lose, I still have a good time. And I will say, usually when I play this game with friends, we play the co-op variant, where we're all working together, and there is no traitor, and there are no secret objectives. We're all just working to complete that one main objective, in which case we flip it to the hardcore side of the objective card, which is harder, but we're all working together at least. But even then, we still lose a lot. And I think it's so hard to play with secret objectives so that you have added things you have to do. And on top of that, somebody might be a traitor. I don't know how anyone wins this game if there is an actual traitor in the game. So if you don't like really difficult challenges, all while dealing with some very sad, stressful themes, this might not be the game for you. But if you like fighting zombies and playing as interesting characters and telling multi-layered stories based on the events that occur and the cool Crossroads deck, then I highly recommend this game. I'm all about games that are dripping with theme and story. So that is Dead of Winter from Plaid Hat Games. I would say go out and buy it. It's a good one. Thank you for watching. If you like these videos, please like and subscribe. Tell all your friends. Follow me on social media. That helps me out. And tune in again. Thanks for watching. Bye.